Hello guys, welcome to our channel and the topic that we will learn today is how can we make a daybook management. And here you can see the different formats. Like I already made the boxes in which we will just need to put the data, and that data will give us the conclude result. And here you can see I made the serial number, day, date, and then particulars. And here you can see the receipt methods. Like we have four receipt methods in which cash, card, internet payment, check, and after that you will get the total amount, and which is the transaction amount, and in the last one the description of any transaction which you want to give, so that you will get the enhanced knowledge or enhanced information of the particular transaction. So how can this type of function will help out to you to make the daybook management? So we'll start our lecture with the first data. Like here you can see the serial number. So I just put our first transaction, and in the first transaction I just write one, and for a day I just write here Monday, and the day, and here you can see the day book. So our day book starts from 1 for 1st May till 30 May. So we just put the dates according to it. Like I just put the 1st May, and here I like the particulars. In the particulars you can write any transactions, like rent payment, and in the last receipt methods. For the receipt methods, as I told you that we just take the four methods, and so it's up to us how can we just use the methods. I just use your data validation functions. So how can we use data validation function? You have to just go here in the data tab, and here in this data tab you can see the data validation function. You have to just click on it, and in this you can see the data validation. So you have to just select the data validation, and in this data validation you can see the list, and in the list you only need to select the four transactions, and you have to just click on it, and then you just need to drag it. So you just need to just click on it, and it will tell you the transaction method. So first transaction method is cash, and how much cash? I just write here 5,000. Then description, and description is rent pay to the owner. That is the first description. You can just make the length increment so that you will get the better description. And how you will get the total amount here? You have to just use here the sum if function. Like you have to just use equals to sum if bracket open. Now you can see the data, like in which it wants range. So our range starts from the cash or receipt methods. So you have to just select all these, and then you have to just write a comma, then it says criteria. So criteria is selected, which means receipt methods. Now comma, and then it says sum range. So you have to just select the total amounts, and you have to just close the bracket for it. Now you just need to drag it down, so you will get the total amount here, and in the last you can see the total receipt amount. So you have to just write your sum function for the whole values. So you have to just select all the boxes and close the bracket, you will get the amount. I just highlight or color it so you can get the better differentiate, or you can differentiate it betterly. I just bold it. So this is what we learned, and I just now make another transition, like 2nd, and I just made this transition on Tuesday, and that is of 2nd May, and that I just got the car payment, and I got this payment by card, and the payment is 25,000, and payment of rent by car This is our second, and here you can see the increment in the card. If I just made the third payment, and if I just right here, I made the payment on Wednesday, 3rd May, and payment will be of sales order, and the payment is made by the internet, and the payment is made of 10,000 and sale of order to customers. So you will get the data here, and if I just write here 4, and in this I just made the payment on Thursday, which is 4 May, and I received the commission, and the commission I received is through check, and the check is of 8,000, and commission from customer. Now 5th, I just write here on Friday I made the payment of, and here you see service charges, and you can see the difference. Now you just write the card payment, and here you already see the 25,000 of card payment, and if I just made another 5,000 payment, so you can see the increment of 5,000, so the total becomes 30, which means first card payment of 25,000 and second card payment is 5,000. So it gave the sum of the card payment. This is how the sum function works. And if I just write here service charges from customer, and if I just write here again another last one, like I just made the payment on Saturday, and here I just write here, and in this I again got the shop payment, and in the shop payment if I just got the payment through internet, and internet I've got 3,000, and you just go here and check the shop payment received. You have to just write your receipt, so you can see the shop or internet payment. I already made 10,000 and then internet payment of 3,000, so it becomes 13,000, and here you can see the difference, and the total amount which we got is 56,000. You can write here like in the decimals, so you get the better understanding of it. This is what we made today. We just made the formats, and in this formats you can see we made the particulars and receipt methods. For the receipt methods we used the data validation function, and with the help of data validation function you just need to drag it, it will tell you the amount. If I just change the method from card to check, so you can check the amount increased by check and decreased by card. If I just again get the card, so you can see the change of the amount. This is how we use sum if function, and the balances is written here, and these are the descriptions. This is what we learned today. This is very simple technique, and with the help of this simple technique you can summarize the things like we got the payment through cash of 5,000, we got the total payment through card is 30,000, we got the total payment of cards from payment of cards from internet payment 13,000, and we got the total payment of from check of 8,000, and the total amounts we received from different methods is 56,000. This is what we learned today, and this is what we got from our example. If you face any confusion in this video, you can write in our comment section, we will surely give you a reply. And please share, like and support our channel by subscribing it. Thank you so much.